this is what boredom does make you eat. Waiting for rideshare calls. I'm also driving with Lyft. I just got signed up this week. The Lyft driver app is not very user-friendly like Uber's. Uber displays everything on the screen for you without touching it. Lyft, you have to press a button to see the name of the person you're picking up, address of where you're going. Uber, everything is displayed. You don't have to do anything. Oh well. At the end of the day, it's all money. The last few days I've been up in McMinnville and Newburgh. It's good. Longer rides than Corvallis. Less rides. Same amount of pay as Corvallis. So the wear and tear in the car should be better. Closer to Portland, been getting more Portland calls. I can't drive in Portland because I'm registered outside of the city for both rideshare companies. Bergen Wilsonville is the closest I can get to Portland for picking up. I cannot pick up in the city. I can drop off anywhere. Rush hour. Let me switch it around. No. Just did a run for Lyft. And this is what rush hour in Mac looks like. Main drag 99. it's a nice day, warmed up from the 50s to 73 degrees. You gotta have coffee. Best coffee there is, McDonald's, even when it's cold. Still tastes good. But up in Dundee, just a few miles up the road, I think it's Dundee, there's a coffee place, a drive-through, called the Bikini Bean. You gotta go check that out sometime. Do they actually wear bikinis serving coffee? Keep you posted on that one. Probably cost you $10 for a little coffee too. Just for the novelty of it. Well, there's nothing like sitting, doing nothing, twiddling your thumbs, watching traffic, waiting on a call. So why I got a new car? Well, thanks to Uber, I got a new car. And no, Uber did not buy it for me. Didn't sponsor it, didn't do nothing. All they did was did a policy change from 15 years or newer down to 10 years or newer. So now my 2003 Corolla that I drove last year is no longer eligible to drive ever again. So, I put about, I guess, 40,000 miles on that car since I owned it. I bought it in the end of 2017 after salmon fishing in Alaska. The bulk of it was with Uber. I did 26,000 miles alone with Uber. The rest of it was road trips. So now when I came back here to Oregon, after wintering in Anegada, it was all set to go. Just had to put insurance on the Corolla and start driving until I got a notice that I can't drive until I get a newer car. Well, when you're broke and can't afford to buy a new car, still go and buy a new car. And that's what I did. So, while I was in Coos Bay, I had to get an oil change on the Corolla anyhow. And I've been sitting there for 6 months without one. Full oil from when I parked it up. Then on the way back home, I stopped in at Coos Bay Toyota, walked along the lot, and the girl came out asking me if she can help me. I said, yeah, looking for a car, 2009 or newer. She said, oh, probably want to go over there to the other car lot. So I did. Met the sales guy over there, at a used car lot. Sam, good guy. If you want to buy a car, check out Sam at 101 Budget Auto Sales next to Coos Bay Toyota. And no, this is not a sponsor video from them or anything like that. Just hitting them up. So I traded in the Corolla, and the trade-in value went down as my down payment for this car. So this is a 2018 Kia Forte 5 LX, which is a hatchback. That's pretty much what I wanted anyhow, was a hatchback, essentially, but I wasn't expecting it to be anytime soon. So, after the normal process of buying a car as a dealer, a while, being a first-time buyer, shitty credit. Sam came back and said, well, we got you approved. Let's go test drive it. Because I refused to test drive the car before the numbers were ran. Because it didn't make no sense to drive a car before numbers were running. To do what? Waste some time. And the payments was very reasonable, within what I wanted, the range I wanted. So it's all set to go. I guess it was by the time I walked in and walked out and drove out, I guess it was, I would say 3 hours, give or take. So anyways, it seemed like buying a car was the easiest part. The stressful part now was getting it registered with Uber. They did not like the temporary registration from DMV for some reason. But yet they accepted the temporary from the Corolla. So, I don't know. So long story short, I had to drive to Portland, which is a 4-hour drive, to the Uber office to activate the new car on my account. In 2 days I was in and out. Since then, since last week, I lost half a week, so since I got here, now I'm hustling to make up for lost time. Alright, so I'm going back to Corvallis. First, on the left-hand side of the road, I think it's Hazelnut. And here on the right-hand side of the road, is either the annual ryegrass or the tall fescue. I could just be talking bullshit too. I don't know. I'm just guessing. I don't know. Anyhow. They don't put signs next to their crop like you see in California. So, I, you know. shot guess, but anyhow.
Alright, so back to...
Head into Corvallis. Nothing wrong with McMinnville, or the locals call it Mac. Longer rides there, yes, but you gotta wait a while. And I don't like waiting, sitting around. It gets very boring. So, the money is there. I don't like waiting, you know, so I like to be on the go.
So,
that's why I'm heading back to Corvallis. Corvallis is shorter trips, busier, and we got a problem there. Anyhow, busier, same money, the money is there, so depends what you want to do. You want to be busy and get make the same amount of money, or you want to sit around and make the same amount of money?
I like to be busy.
Because when I'm bored, I like to eat. I eat too much. What they got going on now? Oh, friggin' detour. No detour. God bless. Shut down in Mac parts of it. I have these flaggers up 24 hours a day running traffic. Anyhow, that's why I'm going back and forth about this to drive. But my apps are still on, Uber and Lyft still on. So you never know. On the way up here, I was in Dallas and had to go back to Independence for a drive. For a ride. So you just never know. Anyhow, check out the scenery. Enjoy. Thank you.
hundreds up here. I'll have to do a vineyard winery tour one of these days. This one is huge. I didn't get the name of it. Five Star Cellars or something. It's south of Amity on 99 West. The name could be wrong though. Check out that house on the hill. Hope you didn't think I was serious. Monroe Street. Where all the action is on the West U campus. Similar to Mill Street at Arizona State. I still think Arizona State was more hardy animals than OSU students. I'm going to wrap up this blog number 5. Dark can of flowers. 7:15 now. And so I'm just chilling here on Monroe. Waiting for the next ride. Since I've been back, I haven't slowed down. Back to back rides. Alright guys, I'll see you in the next video. Subscribe to my channel. And be sure to check out my website at ironstores.com.